If you have used digital drawing softwares like Photoshop or Clip Studio, you've probably seen this tiny little option called anti-aliasing. If you're new to digital art, you're probably wondering what that is. Don't you worry, because in today's video, I'll be discussing what anti-aliasing is and the effect it has in your drawing. I'll also be telling you when and where to use this function. In order to explain this properly, I actually prepared two line arts. One, I use anti-aliasing for inking, and for the other, I turned it off. Now, it doesn't look like there's much difference between the drawings, but that is because we are zoomed out. Let's zoom these drawings in. Now, do you see the difference? Type in the comments what difference you see. Come on, I'll give you 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Okay, if you've answered that the edges of the lines in the left are softer or the lines on the right are jagged or sharper, give yourself a pat in the back, because that's exactly what aliasing does. Basically, if you turn on anti-aliasing, when you do a brush stroke or create a selection and fill it, it makes the edges softer. You might think this isn't such a big deal, but depending on what kind of art you'll be making, anti-aliasing can be helpful or detrimental to your process. For example, if you're doing digital painting, anti-aliasing is so useful because you can manipulate the softness of your brushes, which is ideal for adding those nice gradients. For digital inking, I suggest turning this setting off. That is because it's easier to use paint bucket or magic wand when you're adding flat colors on your drawing. When you turn anti-aliasing off, you will notice that the brush strokes are just one singular color. When you turn this on, it will introduce different tiny pixels of colors, so when you use the magic wand, there's a tendency that some of these tiny pixels will not be selected, which can leave this weird white stuff when you fill the insides with color. The downside of turning anti-aliasing off when using it on inking is that it might make your drawing look jaggedy. To rectify this, it's best to use a large canvas for your drawings, around 3000 pixels or more, so that the jagged lines are not obvious when you zoom it out. Another thing where it's best to turn off anti-aliasing is creating pixel art. As we have established earlier, turning this setting on will introduce other unwanted colors on your brush. Because pixel art requires precision in colors and strokes, it's best to turn this off. That's pretty much anti-aliasing in a nutshell. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. I have more tutorials in this channel that you can watch, like this video about how to scan and clean your traditional drawings so that you can prepare it for digital coloring.